Alright, let's talk about while loops. In contrast to for loops, we can use while loops if we don't know in advance how many iterations we actually need. So one of the most common examples is when you want to read a text file and you read that line by line. And you don't really know when the file is gonna end, so you don't know how many lines it actually contains. And you have to basically iterate until you come to a so-called end of file symbol. So that's one of those most common scenarios where you don't know in advance, well, how many iterations will I actually need, so I'm gonna have to use the while loop. But since we're still talking about the basics, we actually have to look at a more simple example, just to get to know the while loop and how it works. So let's create a value called x, and I'm gonna set it to 9. And let's say we want to print out all the numbers from x down to 0. Now, of course, in this case, we know how many iterations we're going to need. But since we haven't really talked about any input and output, we're going to have to use a simple example like this. Now, first of all, we're going to type the while keyword. And again, we use parentheses to write our condition. And in this case, it's x supposed to be greater or equal to 0. Now, inside our loop, which we again specify using our curly braces, we can just print out x and do x equals x minus 1. And again, I did the same mistake, so I'm going to make this a variable, and now I can reassign x. Now, if we want to decrease x by 1 like this, what you will often see used in code is just x minus minus. And this is the exact same thing, it's just going to set x to x minus 1, but it's a more concise way to write it because you need it a lot when you use loops. Similarly, you could also do x plus plus to increment it by 1. But in this case, of course, we want to decrease its value so that we actually reach our condition. Now let's quickly run this. And it works fine. It prints all the numbers from 9 down to 0. Now you may have noticed that we can actually simulate our for loops using the while loop. So if we want to create a while loop that basically does the same thing as the for loop we've seen in the last lecture, so a loop which goes from numbers 1 to 10, we can use this also by starting at 0 or at 1 and then use a while condition while I lower or equal to 10. And inside here we can do whatever we want, the same what we would have written in our for loop. And then we can say I plus plus. So this would be equivalent to our for I in 1 to 10. Do something. And you can see that the for loop is much more concise in this case, and it's also less error prone because you don't have to specify your variable and you also don't have to remember to increment it. So for these kinds of cases, the for loop is the better choice. But in other cases, you may want to use the while loop instead, because another one of its advantages is that inside our parentheses, we can basically have any condition we want. So we could do something like while user dot is online, if we had this object, and just do something as long as our user is online, for example. So we can have arbitrary conditions, which is not the case in the for loop in Kotlin. So you could say that while loops are more powerful in a way, but keep in mind that the for loop is the better choice and it's more concise and more readable if you know in advance how many iterations you will actually need. Alright, so that's all about the while loop, and I'll see you in the next lecture. Thanks so much for watching. If you've learned something new in this video, please make sure to give it a like. And also, if you're new here, hit the subscribe button and the bell icon to be notified of any new tutorials. If you want to watch more, check over here, and I will see you in the next video.